The team told me of a dog that's back in this area that just came in that is really struggling. Oh, hi. Oh, hi, sweetie. Oh, yeah, you see it? You may not be able to see it. Hi. You wanna tell me about it? You're moving so slow. Hi. Oh, let's hear. I'm going to show you guys. Hi, can I come in?
Hi. Hi, little one. Hi. Hi, come here. Come here. Hi. Oh, I don't want to touch you right there. Oh, that is really bad. What happened? Oh, my goodness. It's like sad and kind of cute in a sad way, but I don't want to touch you right there. Can I touch you right here? Hi. Can I sit down with you? Come here. Hi. Whoa. Hi. Hi, come here.
You want to come into my lap?
Okay. Come on. You want to sit right there? Okay, you can do that. What's going to be best for you? Whoa. It's awkward, sorry. Hi. So, okay, can you guys see it now? That's so heartbreaking. It's sad but cute. It's almost like he's got a bee sting. We're gonna try to find out his info here in a minute, but the tough part about this sort of thing too is, hi. It could be a bee sting, but more likely it's like a tumor or an abscess. Sometimes terminal, hopefully treatable. Or a bee sting, well, I mean, I don't hope it's a bee sting, but hopefully it's like not as serious. But you can tell it's weighing heavy on him. Oh, hi, buddy. I'm sorry. Hi. This is that 2 minute drop. I tell you, like every time I sit with a dog, I'm 2 minutes in and my heart just sinks. And then what do? We get rid of that because we are here for him right now in the moment. And we are showing him some love because he deserves that. Hi. Just in this moment right here, this love can really make all of the difference to him. Even if he came from a really loved family and they're on their way to get him right now, just even this moment and this place of unknown fear, it can go a long way. He is a cute little guy though. How old are you? What do we think? Do you want to try a treat? I hesitate to try a treat because I don't know if it's going to hurt when he chews, but I think we try, you know? Here. We'll make it really, really small. Really small bite. Oh, there you go. Oh, that's so cute. Oh, you like treats? You like treats? Yeah, you're a good boy. Hi. Okay, you're tree motivated. That's good. I think he just came in. I'm gonna ask here in a minute what his story is when Alexis comes back over here. Hi. Your hair is pretty. Look at your ears. They're like flowing. What kind of dog do you think he is?
I don't know.
Hi.
Because he almost looks like a little shepherd of some sort, but he's so little.
Yeah.
He looks spaniel.
Spaniel, that.
To me.
Could be.
I think that's probably right. Some sort of spaniel mix. Hi, am I okay right here? Yeah. Yeah. I bet he wants up in my lap. I bet he's a perfect candidate for the scoop. Should we give it a whirl? Let's give it a minute here. I don't want to grab him too soon if he's in pain. Hi.
Yeah, he might have other spots that are painful I don't know about.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'm gonna check him out. Just kinda. I am no vet or professional, but he's really dirty underneath, but he's not like dirty, he's got some allergy stuff going on back here, it looks like, but I mean, he's pretty clean and well-groomed. It wouldn't surprise me if his owners are gonna come get him if he just got out or something like that. Hi. He's putting pressure on that swollen area, so hopefully it's not hurting him too bad. Oh, can you know tricks? Here, you want to shake? You want to shake? Can you shake? I can't look at your face and... It's like, how do you say no to a face like that? I'm trying to give it to him on the top of his mouth so I don't accidentally bump the bottom of his mouth where he's got that little swollen area. It looks like a bee sting. I mean, it's like cute and sad, but I don't think it's a bee sting. You know, it also kind of looks like a snake bite, but he's so little that if that was a snake bite, that would be, I don't know if he'd still be around. Unfortunately, it might be more of like a tumor or an abscess or something like that. I hope not, because I don't think he's a senior. I mean, he looks pretty young. I don't want to check his teeth because if this area right here is painful, I don't want to cause more pain, and I'm not a vet, you know, so I'll leave that to the pros when he goes to health check here just a little bit. It's like there's so much concern in his eyes, it just melts your heart. Do we know how old he is?
We don't right now.
Okay. A boy, right?
I thought
I saw that. What's his story?
So he does have a microchip. So he does belong to somebody.
Okay, that's good. You have a microchip. That's a good thing. Okay, tell me more. Tell me more good things, hopefully.
But the problem is, they're saying right now to not return to owner at this time without animal control counseling.
Okay.
And the reason why is because apparently the dog had a zip tie around his neck. And facial swelling, blood on the fur, and pus discharge on his feet.
I am so sorry. And you do not deserve that. I don't have any words for that, and I'm sorry you went through that, and you don't deserve that. And to find out that swelling is likely from a zip tie and probably, you know, broken arteries or blood vessels or who knows what, just painful damage, is just infuriating. And I know I felt it for a minute. If you're watching this, just the anger that should boil up inside you is acceptable. This is why we have animal control, and this is why I do what I do, and it's for hard situations like this. And I don't have words. I can't put into words the heartache that you feel when you sit with a dog and you know that. But I do know that what I try to do in these situations where I'm angry and tears start to fill my eyes is I wish that away, because it's not fair for him to feel that again. And they do. He does. And I think instead what I do is I fast forward to what his life will be like. And he's here now, and he's okay, and he's safe, and he's at Animal Friends of the Valleys with an animal control team that care a lot about him, and they aren't going to just let him go back into a bad situation. And from here, he's going to be okay. The situation's going to be assessed. If he doesn't go back to that family, he's going to go to a loving family that really cares about him and really loves him. And just think about, if you had this dog, how much you would spoil him and love him and give him all the treats he deserved and train him and go take him on walks and car rides and let him sit on the couch with you and snuggle while you watch your favorite movie. That's what you have to do to get back to this spot of going, okay, it's okay, because he's living in the now, he's living in the moment. He right now knows that he's safe and that he's okay, and whatever he's been through is going to be okay from now, because he can feel that from me. And that's how we get to a point of focusing on the positive and that there is good in this world and you're going to be okay. What should we name him? Kind of looks like a Wilbur. Wilbur? You like Wilbur? Wilbur? Oh, you like Wilbur? Here, yeah, let's start. Wilbur, Wilbur, here you go. Good boy, Wilbur. Hi, buddy. Oh, you're going to be okay, Wilbur. You're going to be okay. Yeah. Good boy, Wilbur. Good boy, Wilbur. Hi. I will personally go talk to animal control and get to the bottom of this. And like I always say, reuniting pets with their family is really important. But in this situation, I would like Wilbur to be with a family that will not twist tie him. I'm not the decision maker at the end of the day, but I will go assert my influence. That is for sure. Hi, Wilbur. Hi. Okay, I started to get back in that space, that anger space. do this too. Leave a comment of love and support for Wilbur. Like, that goes a long way. He can feel it. It resonates with these guys. So I believe it makes a difference. And share this, because the whole world deserves to know about Wilbur and how amazing of a dog he is. And he deserves to be adopted by someone that will spoil him to no end. I mean, you still have to have some rules and boundaries and stuff. But you know what I'm saying. Oh my gosh, if we could take a dog right now, I would just run out of here with him. People would be like, did Rocky leave? I didn't even see him. They're like, well, what was that white streak that just ran through the lobby? Because I have a white shirt on, not because I'm streaking. Didn't sound right. Anyway. Oh, that's why I couldn't figure out what that was. Like, if it was a tumor or, but yeah, it's so abnormal. Like, I've never seen anything like that. Because a lot of time a bite, they'll also swell up like around their top area of their nose. And it didn't look like a tumor or anything.
Well, the good news is that hopefully he does have a full recovery. It's not like a,
yeah,
a tumor that will give him cancer or anything like that. So
I just never,
that's the positive, I think, in this.
I think so. Yeah, he'll heal up. I mean, he still might have, kind of that double chin right there, but I think, knowing his story, I think he's just perfect the way he is, double chin or not. Okay, you want more treats? Okay, all right. Good boy. Good boy. Yeah. Yeah, it's a good boy. And now, I said he was groomed and stuff and clean, but like, now that I look at him, I can see, now that he's closer to me, he hasn't been groomed. He's got mats at the end here, and he's got like some fuzz stuck on his face or his ear.
You don't see blood on his fur. They might have wiped it along when they...
Oh, yeah, back here, that's right.
Blood on the fur was found, whether that's...
I thought that was allergies. Eyes. Yeah, I thought that was like a red allergy reaction.
Blood, probably.
It is.
Probably, maybe they wiped him away he's only been in here for literally overnight. So he's very new. They haven't done anything yet, except obviously cut that zip tie off that was on him.
Yeah, I don't want to touch it, but it is blood, but I don't want to touch him in case that's his sensitive area, which would be understandable. Don't lose hope. I know these situations are hard, and it's just hard to hear. But don't lose hope. He's going to be okay. And this is why we do this. And it's why you're watching, because you believe in this, right? So Wilbur is going to be okay from here. I'd love to have you as a subscriber and just follow this channel. I'll keep everyone updated and become a member. If you want to support what we're doing and you want to help more dogs, I'd love to have you be a part of that. Members get the information first. If you want to support more, I'll put up our Sitting with Dogs shirt and our treats. And you can go donate to Animal Friends of the Valleys in Wildomar, California. He's going to be on hold for certain for the full 10 days as we figure out what's going on. So please hold. Don't call or email the shelter. We don't want to overwhelm them. Just think about, if a lot of people see this video, just the thousands and thousands of people that might message the shelter. If you live closely or if you follow me for updates, that would be best. Wilbur, I love you, and I'm sorry you've been through this, and I'm sorry from the bottom of my heart, buddy. And I'm gonna leave you with a giant treat stick when I leave here, so you can just chow down on it. Like, this one has me genuinely sad. I pull out of these, and I am going to have a good attitude about this, but oh man, it hits you. I know you guys can feel this too, like when you're watching these, but it hits you sometimes. Sometimes more than others, and it's the holidays, and so.
Kelly and I were shocked too, back here reading the notes on that. Like, yeah. None of us would have guessed what the reason was for that swelling.
Yeah, I've just, I think you always hope for the best, and every time something like this, you see something like this, it just hits you hard. And yeah, but Wilbur's a good boy. I don't want to leave. People always say in the comments, like, oh, how do you leave? Or you just leave them? Yeah, it's not easy. But we have more dogs we gotta show love to and comfort. And hopefully this helps warm him up a little bit and show him, like, people are good. He may not know that. He may have never experienced that people are good outside of the animal control officer picking him up and saving him and showing him love. But you're going to find a lot more people that love you now. I guarantee it, because we have an awesome dog-loving community out there. Okay?
Okay, update. Wilbur is in isolation right now, so he is not available for adoption. I guess there's more going on than even what we can see. I will keep everyone updated. I'll put the link down in the description below, too, so you can stay updated. Make sure you subscribe. That way you get notifications. But please, no calls or emails or showing up to the shelter, because Wilbur is currently not available, and it might be a little bit until he's all healed up. But the good news is, and the most important thing, is he's going to be okay from here, and updates will come soon.